Hello, welcome to today's video. Today we want to show you how we develop filters here at Cubro. Just at the beginning, tell you about the application. So what we have is, we have 8 times 100 gigabit. This is 3G and 4G traffic, which we try to manipulate with our session master, the EFA3200, and then feed traffic to different probes. Just at the beginning, tell you about the input traffic, and that we will show you on our Cubro poster. So where we are with our input traffic, the first thing we are doing is we are tapping the S1U traffic. That's the user traffic in the 4G network. Moreover, what we have is the S11 traffic. That's the signaling traffic, which we also have. And we also have S61A traffic. And also what we don't see here is the same we have also for 3G traffic. We have the 8 times 100 gig, we said. Total traffic capacity we are handling here is around 400 gigabit. The 400 gigabit now, of course, we need to do some filtering just to feed the right traffic to our different probes, which I will explain in a minute. The first point we are doing in the filtering is we are dropping some traffic. And the first filter we need is, we have a filter called DSCP, value 0, and this traffic we are dropping. Okay, so this is the first thing, just remove some traffic which is not needed for further analysis. So now we need to consider signaling and user traffic, and we need to split that up. And the first thing I'm doing is I'm taking out signaling. How we can filter that? We just take a UDP filter, a UDP port filter, 2123. This gives us all the signaling traffic. And how we process that? We feed this now to one output, and we feed it here. Let's consider this is a 10G port called 32.1, and that traffic we can directly feed to our signaling probe. That signaling probe will analyze all the signaling in the network, but as a complication, the signaling also needs to go to our IMSI filtering probe. An IMSI filtering probe just will take all the user traffic and all the signaling that belongs to one specific call, to one IMSI. How we can do that? I do this just with mirrors. That means we'll just make a copy and say this is my interface number 2, and then I take my mirror and I have it here, and I have 2 probes, so I need it again. Make another mirror. So this is my mirror 1, and this is my mirror 2. What I can do now is I just connect it here, and I just connect this here. So now we are happy with all the signaling is where we want. The next thing is, of course, we need to user traffic. The difference between user and signaling is the traffic volume, of course. User traffic is much, much higher. So first thing is, I need to filter out from the whole traffic. I can do again UDP port filter. And it's the 2152. Okay, I can feed this now to the probes, but it's too much traffic for one probe, so we need to do load balancing. So I define a load balancing group. A load balancing group consisting of 2 interfaces. So one goes here, and the other one goes here. And important is for load balancing is we are using here GTP load balancing, which means we're doing load balancing based on the inner IP. GTP load balancing. And this traffic we feed in here, and that group here just distributes the traffic nicely, just that both filter probes have the same input probe. So now there's one complication at the end. We have one specific probe called DNS probe. That probe should get all the DNS traffic. DNS traffic is part of the user, traffic. So it's already included here, and we send it out. So what can we do is, we need another copy of this traffic here and feed it here, plus a filter criteria. How can we filter DNS? We DNS is port 53. That's the, would be an easy filter, but remember, port 53 is the inner port. Okay, so we develop another filter. That's called GTP inner UDP port 53. So that's my filter. And what I do is, I take another mirror, take the mirror here to this filter, that's my M3. And this one, the result of this, you just fit here to a port 32.4, and then we have it here in the DNS probe. So it, now we are finished here, meaning here we have all the user traffic and signaling, we can do the filtering. Here we have all the signaling, and here we have only DNS traffic. This is what it is. So we are done. Now we could do, of course, using the web GUI, and this is how we develop filters, and of course we're also happy to do your filters.